Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, North Schuylkill. I'm Zach Zimmerman.
And I'm Sadie Chakotis.
This past weekend, the North Schuylkill Marching Band performed in the annual Tournament of Bands. The Tournament of Bands is one of the largest competitive band organizations in the country. It allows performance opportunities for indoor guard, majorette, percussion, and dance. Tournament of Bands is made up of 13 different regions from New York to North Carolina. North Schuylkill is currently ranked 2 out of 27 bands in Group 2A, trailing first place by about 2.5 points. Bands are scored on music, visuals, and general effect. The band also had the opportunity to perform in a crowd of thousands at the Bloomsburg Fair on Monday. Let's check out some footage from the both events.
Night's opener pays homage to a musical icon lost earlier this year, David Bowie, in his collaboration with Queen, Under Pressure.
Erica Coles has more with Jasmine Locke about what it takes to conduct the band.
Hi, I'm Erica Coles with In the News, here with drum major Jasmine Locke. So Jasmine, how did North Schuylkill do at last year's championships, and what are your hopes for this year?
We placed fourth last year with a score of 90.12, and that was the second time we broke the record for the score last year. And my hopes are first for the championships.
What does a drum major do, and why are they important to the band?
The drum major is the student leader that's on the podium and conducts, and basically my job is to just communicate the tempo from me to the band and hope that they don't tear.
So I know this year is your first year conducting the competition band, so do you miss marching or do you like being drum major more?
I like them both equally because they're both just as fun.
Are there any upcoming performances that the band has?
Well, the football band has a performance at the football game, pregame actually, at Lee Highton on Friday, and the competition band has a competition at Conrad Weiser this weekend.
Thank you, Jasmine.
Continuing with the news with our band, we have some exclusive photos from the sidelines of the Lincoln Financial Field with Brandon Harris and Mr. T as the Philadelphia Eagles defeated the Pittsburgh Steelers 34-3.
To make the ring.
week, millions of Americans watched the presidential debate between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, and many don't feel confident about either choice. Voting for a president can be a daunting task, but luckily, voting for a queen isn't. With homecoming just around the corner, we will soon be crowning a new queen of North Schuylkill. Rachel Cataldo has interviews with the five seniors on this year's court.
I'm Rachel Cataldo with In the News. I'm here with the 2016 homecoming court. Rebecca, which qualities set you apart from the other homecoming candidates?
One quality that would set me apart would be that I'm like the shortest one out of the five, and that all of the candidates that were selected for court and were not selected for court were all humble and kind.
Heather, which Spirit Day are you looking forward to participating in the most?
I'm looking forward to participate in Decades Day.
Why is that?
Because I like the movie The Breakfast Club.
So you're going with a 1980s theme?
Yeah.
Mary Alice, how does it feel to represent the school as a part of the homecoming court?
Well, initially I was really shocked and surprised, and right now it just feels, it's such a great honor to be able to be chosen out of our whole class. And I'm just really excited for the week and to see what happens.
Grace, out of all of the events that happened during Spirit Week, which one is your favorite?
I really liked just the whole week of homecoming because of the Spirit Days, and I really like to dress up and go all out for the week.
I do too. It's always pretty fun. Lizzie, out of all of the people that have been a part of homecoming courts in the past, who do you look up to the most?
Mr. Smith.
And why is that?
I've never seen anybody look more classy in a dress.
Fair enough. Back to you, Zach and Sadie.
Following the homecoming football game against Jim Thorpe, there will be a dance in the high school cafeteria. There will be snacks and refreshments available, as well as live music from the local celebrity, Shadler. The dance will be held between 8:30 and 10:30 p.m. Admissions are $3. In our first Flashback Friday, we're heading back to 1991 when our band's sophomore album changed the face of music. Richie Zahanek has more with fans of this monumental album.
Good morning, North Schuylkill. I'm Richie Zahodnik here with Garrett Kress. And for those of you who don't know, September 24th marks the 25th anniversary of Nirvana's album, Nevermind. So, Garrett, when was the first time you became familiar with Nirvana?
When I was younger, towards kindergarten, my father used to listen to Nirvana, Metallica, and Nirvana just really grown on me from driving to school every day with my father, just listening to it every day with him.
I've been raised on Nirvana. I can't tell you the first time I listened to them. My mom's a huge fan, and really wore off on me.
The first time I heard Nirvana was on the way to school on a mix CD. I think the first song I heard by them was Smells Like Teen Spirit. It's probably one of their most famous songs of all time.
And how do you think it impacted you personally?
Kind of emotionally, kind of attitude-wise, just kind of built up that grunge feeling, and really just kind of like there for me when I wanted to have a good time. I just listened to that, chill in my room.
Well, Nevermind was a sort of a comfort album for me, if that makes sense. It was around when I was having a tough time.
And how do you think it impacted music as a whole?
Well, Nirvana was a huge band, and they just got grunge just deep into the 90s, and they were just blowing people away, just amazing. But vocally and instrumentally,
right. Took music by storm.
I don't know, I wasn't there. It made my dad hate modern music.
Yeah. They brought this underground scene of alternative rock and grunge to more of a mainstream area, kind of blossomed from Seattle and swept the globe, you know, and we have Nirvana to thank for that. Hey, good luck tonight.
Thanks.
Nobody likes Lee Hyten. No.
Back to you.